everyone, welcome back to Games by Destiny. Today we are going to do a little bit different video in which we are going to show you how to set up a laboratory. It is very difficult to find what you need to have an actual laboratory, so we thought that we might show you what we have actually used in order to set up our experiments.
In fact, we show you our personal laboratory that is made up of different parts. In particular, we'll talk about the reagents of our laboratory and also about the glassware that is in it. So guys, the first important things to say about the lab are the reagents. In fact, the reagents are the most important part of a chemical reaction, and here we have some. The more common reagents are, for example, the sulfuric acid, the hydrochloric acid, and also other reagents like, for example, sodium hydroxide. Also, we want you to know that there are some things that you can take from your home that can be used as chemical reagents, such as, for example, acetic acid, and also sodium chloride, that is the common salt, and also sodium carbonate, and of course water, but it must be distilled water, and finally sugar.
Okay everyone, another important part of our laboratory is the glasswork. The most important thing that you must need to have in your laboratory are the beakers, because only with beakers you are able to mix solution in a clean environment. Also beakers, as you may also know, they are made of a special kind of glass called Pyrex or borosilicate. It is special because it resists high temperatures. In fact, you can heat them on the oven without cracking them, which instead with some with other glasses isn't possible. Other important things are, for example, our cylinders, and we have also some small cylinders to comment these. Then we have some small plates, always made out of glass, and we don't have to forget our glass tubes, which are commonly used in many experiments.
So, besides, it's important to clean our lab equip. In fact, if we don't have something that produces water directly, we have to take some recipient, such as these two ones, and we have to put some water into them in order to wash our equipment in a fast way. So, we have these two things to wash.
Okay everyone, another important aspect of our laboratory are the instruments which we use in order to conduct our experiments. The main ones are, for example, spoons, which have both metal spoons and wooden spoons. Then we have our thermometer in order to measure the temperature. Then also we have a universal paper indicators with which we measure pH. Then we have filter papers, masks, goggles, then we have our scales in order to measure the compounds that we use, gloves of course for security, and we also have an oven in order to heat up solutions and our various compounds in order to make faster the reactions. Okay everyone, a last important aspect that we have to consider of our laboratory are dangerous gases and substances. In fact, sometimes we do very dangerous experiments, and in order to keep us safe, we do them outside. So if you can find a place where you can go, for example this swimming pool, which we often used in our experiments, it would be ideal in order to not endanger yourself and also people around you.
So guys, to sum up what we said, the most important things to have in a lab are an extinguisher, some goggles, and a mask for safety, and also a scale and some filter papers, a beaker with a spoon in order to start our reactions, and also an oven to heat our solution.
So everyone, if you like this video, please let us know in the comments. And if you want to see more amazing videos like these experiments, visit our channel where you can subscribe. So for today's all,
thanks for watching.